Playing God games. been playing God games, building houses with big things with no names on a Commodore 64 to make myself feel wanted. Even pixelated kids, so they can let you down. Pixelated horror fan, threw my kingdom to the ground. It's hard to make amends for those promises you've broken, the things you never spoke about. We gotta get you in the end, there comes a lot. Cause a fight, it's just like you, let's do up in front of a table full of strangers. You realize you're just a stranger to yourself. And this is really what love is. Buy matching jackets for minutes and make each other come the minute then it's over. But even people you don't care about can break your heart. One time my brother had a goldfish and he really loved it when it fell apart. We woke up in the morning, and there was bits of the carpet stuck to the goldfish. It was very upsetting, and committed suicide. And it's hard to make amends, and the promises you built on, the things you never spoke about, they're gonna get you in the end, they're come to life. The cause of fight is a swanky restaurant, in front of a table full of strangers, you realize you're just a stranger to yourself. This is my tribute to Kevin Rowland and Dexter's Midnight Runners. If anyone watching, I want someone to say something nice about Kevin Rowland.
He's
great. Good, please. Tonight, I think I'm going to listen to Dexter's Midnight Runners and then cry myself to sleep. Think of all I do. I was Kevin Rowland, it was June 1982, and here come at me. For the first time on the radio, I'll be thinking, oh my god, it's gonna be a hit, it's gonna be even bigger. But do you know, I've got hunches for now when I do gigs, people won't know what I mean. When I talk about my love of old soul records, I just say, shut up and play, come on, I lean. Again, I just create a monster in the shape of a 4-minute, 10-second song in the future. Will I go to 80s nightclubs and hear a room full of idiots singing along to words that are meant to be infected with a sense of genuine feeling? Just nestled between Club Tropicana and Lana Richards dancing on the ceiling, me will go to bed the night. Upset, I'm tired about something you did in 1982. There's no hope tonight over you, and it haunts you when you feel sad like a bag of bones at the foot of the bed, reminding you you should be dead and gone. Like I had that dream today, and all my regrets, and I had to get up and walk away. But when I woke up, the bag of bones was still sat there by my bed. And there was someone laughing in my head about something stupid I once said in a Chinese restaurant that was tight out of place. I started beating to sweat down my face. I got to turn to that moment, the click of a finger, I can access some of the bad memories that linger at the back of my skull, because I easily access everything to maintain a constant level of stress. But even when I'm happy, I'm still kind of sad. And in a way, I'm kind of glad, because I can never really be let down again. Upset, uptight about something you did in 1982. Still holds a knife over you. Well, I do. It's called Kendo Nagasaki, and it's about people discriminating against lonely people because there's 2-for-1 offers at Buenos Aires. Thank you.
Shades and I sat in the dark reading the big pipes for days and just ended up with a headache and thought, oh my god, I'm only 6 months away from becoming a goth. I've got spiked up hair, a permanent cough, and I think I'm gonna die alone. But then grunge came along, started to grow my hair, and it was a project and a farmer everywhere. I went to Lemonhead gigs and pretended I was stoned, just got a little bit more like Evan Zando. Girls come up and tried to hold my hand, and I could never really understand, because all I changed was my hair and the band, because the front of my kitchen put my happy daddy down. The back of the girls got a new Kurt Cobain. You didn't really live or die in vain, because if life's just a series of predetermined maps, and when you're born, it's like you put to a network of skeletal tracks to determine the way different people's lives interact, and things plain to see my blood. Sorry,
I
think it's plain to see. My life is apparently frozen until the 1991 Seattle Grunge explosion. The Kurt Cobain pretty much brought it to the world, or at least brought it to popularity, because I don't think he actually invented Grunge.
And I started writing songs. Is there someone there to listen? And I started writing songs. Is there someone there to listen to those songs I sang?
Older, and
this is a new song, which generally means I forget the words, but it's called Captain Nonentity, and it's about a superhero that can do everything, but he's not really good in social situations, or to girls, and it's making me think he might become a villain. Got a secret of parties and no one remembers me. I can out-torch the human torch, but I don't know talent when it comes to the small talk and screaming. It's just a picture, listening to heroes, got over the thing, stop getting treated underneath the guns, bombs and radiation, but I'm not immune to all this conversation. Trying to crack a joke and no one even cracks a smile, it hurts me pretty badly. And I go out and all I get is my head still swimming and still with regret about all the things I should have said to girls, but not just girls, but yeah, mainly girls. And I can feel it in my head as this carries on, I'm gonna become a super villain instead.
To your face, to your mouth, though, and though you try,
leashed up, stuck in the garden, trying to find my way free, just hoping that one day we'll meet somewhere. You will be my equal, and I ask you what you think of, or what you think you did to me. And before I go, put something like a pitchfork free up front, I'm gonna lock you in the garden and ignore you for 15 years. Make you eat the tin food you gave me, so the tears are rolling down your face. I don't care, I could do the things you did to me, to you. And it's funny, cause I hate you, but inside I really love you. I'm the angriest dog in the world, but you will always be my master. I'm the angriest dog in the world, but you will always be my master. I'm the angriest dog in the world. I'm gonna fight my way through this thing. Someday, somehow, some way, I'm gonna succeed. Find my way into the house, kiss your face, kiss your mouth. Oh, and though you try to put me down, you won't forget the times you let me down. Two more?
Yeah, one or two.
One or two, one, right. I've been a private detective for 17 months.
Houses of Parliament, but I couldn't bring back your love.